Let us now check the problem on design of RC Dex Lab Bridge. So this is little bit lengthy, it may take two parts. So let us see the first part. Let me read the question. Design a reinforced concrete slab culvert for a state highway to suit the following data. Carriageway 2 lane is 7.5 meter wide. Material CM20 grade concrete Fe415 steel. Curbs are 600 mm wide. Clear span is 6 meter. Wearing coat is 80 mm. Width of bearing is 0.4 meter. Loading IRC class A or AA, whichever gives the worst effect. Design RC deck slab and sketch the details of reinforcement in the longitudinal cross section of the slab. So here we are taking IRC AA class because it is the worstest case. And here class AA, that too we are taking track with the tracks, tracked vehicle. Let us see the solution now. Step 1 is to write the permissible stress constants. So we need sigma CBC according to the grade of steel and concrete. So according to the grade of concrete, say sigma CBC, there is a permissible stress in compression in concrete in bending compression, that is 7 Newton per mm square. Sigma ST is 190 Newton per mm square. So initially we have taken in the previous other chapters, for Fe415 we have taken 230 Newton per mm square. But there is a criteria, but I want you people to check. From IS456 table 22, check it. M is 280 by 3 sigma CBC, so we'll get 13. K is M sigma CBC by M sigma CBC plus sigma ST, that is 0.3238. J is 1 minus K by 3, that is 0.89. Q is half J into K into sigma CBC 1.008. These are all design constants. See here, step 2. Depth of the slab and effective span. So here we have to assume the thickness of generally for every 1 meter 80 mm thickness is provided. If it is a 1 meter slab, the thickness should be 80 mm in such cases. So it is 6 meter, right? So they have given overall span in the question, they have given 6 meter. So for 6 meter, for every meter having 80 mm of thickness, 6 into 80. So overall thickness is 480. We are taking it as 500 mm using 25 mm diameter bars. So generally for bridges we use 25 mm diameter bars. We prefer that. So assuming 25 mm clear cover, effective depth, it should not be less than 25 mm. See, effective depth, that is 500 minus this minus overall depth minus 25, that is the diameter plus half of the 25, this is the clear cover plus half of the diameter of the bar. So we'll get effective depth as 462.5 mm. Now given the width of bearing as 0.4 meter in the question. Width of bearing is 0.4 meter in the question they have given us. So effective span, now we have to calculate. So we have to take two parameters and we have to take whichever is least. Least of the following. See, first one is clear span plus effective depth. 6 plus effective depth we have calculated 462.5 mm, that is 0.462 meter. That is totally 6.462 meter. So second one, center to center of bearings. That is 6 plus half the bearing one side, half the bearing one side. As they said, center of bearings. So that is 6.4 meter. So we have to take the least value. So we are taking effective span as 6.4 meter. Now step 3, we have to draw the cross section of the bearing with all the values we got. So this is the clear span, they have given us 7.5 meter. So the curves are 600 mm wide, that is 0.6 meter. So as total is 8700 we got. The thickness of wearing coat is 80 mm they have given us. And the thickness we got it as, thickness of the slab we got it as, this is not TC, this is TS actually, 500 mm. And this height is assumed. And step 4, dead load bending moment. So we have to calculate the bending moments due to the dead load. First one is dead weight of the slab. This is given by this formula, gamma c into ts. In kilonewton per meter square, we have to calculate gamma c into ts. So ts is the thickness of the slab we have. Gamma c is the unit weight of the concrete. That is 24 kilonewton per meter cube. So if so, the dead weight of the slab is this much, 12 kilonewton per meter square. Wearing coat, that is gamma w into tw. Gamma w is here, not unit weight of the water. Here this is the density of varying coat, 22 kilonewton per meter cube. Varying coat density, we have to aware of this. Remember, it is around 22 kilonewton per meter cube. Generally we use that. Tw is thickness of varying coats, that is 0.08 meter. Now find out the varying coat load, that is 22 into 0.08, that is 1.76 kilonewton per meter square. That is the total load. So dead load due to the slab and dead load due to the varying coat. So we have to add them. So total load we got it as 13.76 kilonewton. Now find out the dead load bending moment. After getting the load, let us calculate the bending moment due to that. That is WL square by 8. Here WD refers to the dead load. LE refers to the effective span we got. So calculate, substitute the values in this, you will get this answer. So step 5 is about live load bending moment. So here, class AA tracked vehicle we are talking about. So impact factor is given by this formula. So 25 minus 15 by 4 into LE minus 5. LE here is effective span. This is the only parameter required here. Every entire formula you have to remember. After the substituting, I got 19.7. That is a percentage. Impact percentage we are calculating. Factor in percentages. So next one is effective length of the load. Effective length of the road. So LR. That is given by LT plus 2 times TS plus TW. So as we are talking about the length, you may get doubt why we are talking about the thickness here. Because see here, the load distribution is in this way, 45 degrees. It is assumed to be. So if so, the length will be equal to the horizontal distance will be equal to the vertical distance when it is 45 degrees. So this thickness of varying coat plus thickness of the slab, this vertical load distance, vertical distance is equal to the horizontal distance. So 2 times TS plus TW I have given. So both sides, TS plus TW plus LT, 3.6 plus 2 into 0.5, that is the thickness of slab, plus 0.08 thickness of bearing coat. So we'll get 4.76 meter. In the next point, we have to see effective depth. Width of the slab. The formula is this. B is equal to K into X into 1 minus X by LE plus BW. So we have to see the diagram before substituting the parameters in this. So the X value can be found out with the diagram only. Here in the first case, if it is the span, we are placing the vehicle at the center. If so, see here. When we are placing the vehicle at the center, the center of it is considered to be UDL. So the UDL, so center of gravity of the UDL will be at the center. So the X value will become 3.2. X value is actually the distance from center of gravity to the nearest support. Distance from center of gravity of the load to the nearest support. That is 3.2 meter we have. So what are the parameters required? Again here, K depends on actually B by L ratio. Refer the table for K values. Otherwise, take 2.77 for simply supported slabs. LE is the effective span. We have 6.4 meter. BW is the width of the vehicle. That is given by this formula. Width of the vehicle plus 2 times TW. 0.85 I have given you. Because this is from IS class AA diagram. Please remember that. Plus 2 into 0.08. This is a varying coat. Because we are taking it as, if it is a varying course, we are taking the width of the vehicle, the tire plus 2 times the thickness of varying coat. See here. As it is 45 degrees, it is horizontally, the same value will get. After this, substitute all the values and find out the BE. Effective width, we got it as 5.442 mm. But if the vehicle is placed near to the support with the maintaining clearance, see here, then this will be this much. So from IS class AA loading diagram, we got all the values are from there. So we'll get, actually this is that 5.442 is from center of wheel to outer side, both sides. So I will explain the see here, the time is almost over. Let us see the next part in remaining part of the problem in the next part.